I wanted to also give you an example of how we could apply principles of plot twist to the very concept of the story. Usually a good way of doing it is to find a familiar material, because again, it's a familiar premise. So any kind of familiar material that we already know about, we could use as our foundation and then twist it in some way. So we could even think of it as a
familiar wedding, but a wedding, but the family and the friends, they don't all live in the same city, so they have to travel by bus, by car, or by plane from different parts of the country, or even from different parts of the world. So it's a journey, the traveling to the place of the wedding to make this meeting. So I got all my friends in the wedding, so come. So everybody's traveling.
Mm-hmm.
That's very familiar, and the outcome is everyone enjoys the ceremony, everybody enjoys the party, they remember the good time, the best time, they reenact something, and then the next day, they go the separate ways, everybody to their house, to the city. That's very normal, very, very okay. Regular situation, okay.
Excellent. That's an amazing example. So one of the possible things that this situation can illustrate is the secret clues that people do not recognize as clues. So we could embed in stories that all of those people tell, like as they travel, each of them has their own memories of knowing that couple that is about to be married. Somebody knows the fiancé, the bridegroom. Somebody knew the bride for many years, and we have bits and pieces about that marrying couple embedded into that story. So we could embed something that our audience would not notice right away. Something very small, something very insignificant. And then we deliver a reveal about that married couple, and that reveal will twist everything entirely, like completely. So we could reveal that the married couple actually, that's it's a fake marriage, and both of them are need to be married for some kind of secret reason in order to be married for society, for the status, but not because they love each other. Or we can reveal that there had been a murder in the background of that marriage, and the only way for the marriage to have happened if somebody died before. Or we could end up with the entire story being a collection of clues, and one of the characters who's traveling to the wedding is actually some kind of investigator who is putting together those clues and then reveals the murderer. And it would be a big surprise if the murderer is not the, if we treat either the bride or the groom as a suspect, as a red herring, but the murderer turns out to be somebody else entirely, a priest who was supposed to wed them, something like that. So, there could be some other interesting things to do there. So if it's a wedding situation, we could, what is the range of expected? Again, the range of expected is that everything is going to be fine, everybody will get drunk, everybody is going to have a good time, and somebody get hooked up, somebody will meet somebody during that wedding. Or we could have a negative expectation that the wedding gets canceled by the time they arrive there. That's something still within predictable, right? We would probably still not be shocked by that and would not see it as a plot twist. If all,
Well, but the bride says no.
Or yeah, exactly. Or if she says no, or if somebody, or if all of a sudden there's some romantic character there who turns out to be, in love with the bride, and she is more in love with him than with fiancé, for example. So we could predict these kind of things. One of them says no. What we cannot predict, though, is something else. So what could that be?
I'm squeezing my brain here.
How about the bride disappears all of a sudden?
The the bride disappearing, just okay, the car arrives. Everybody is expecting the bride to come out of the car when the door opens, and the bride is not there.
And exactly.
The bride is not in the car, and the driver was just rushing to tell everybody, hey, the bride is not here. But didn't you pick her up? No, but why didn't you call me for coming? I don't know. I don't have
exactly.
A sense. So,
But imagine this. Imagine that the driver actually found the bride and she got into the car and he never stopped anywhere. And he arrives to the wedding. They open the door and the bride is not there, but there is a puddle of blood there. And all of a sudden, you know, it's this famous closed room mystery kind of thing. But in that case, it's even more surprising because it's a closed room mystery when the closed room was actually moving and there was no way to get out of that car, and the driver would have noticed. So the driver would be a perfect the prime suspect, except there's a camera pointing at the driver inside that limo, and all this time he's shown driving. We can see that. What we cannot see is what is happening behind this non-transparent partition, because it's a bridal car, it's a bridal limo, so it's supposed to be non-transparent so that they can make out in the back of that car. So something happened there and there's a puddle of blood, and it's to be, you know, they investigate and it turns out to be not the bride's blood but somebody else's, and she disappeared. So that would be a plot twist to start a very intriguing story, right? That's one possible way of doing that.
Then why did we call everybody to the city? Then maybe the friends, they tried to get in the investigation and trying to find what happened. So I'm just talking about the point of view, to keep it in the point of view of the friends, not the point of view of the family. Like to keep the story like more outside. The friends trying to investigate. Maybe one of the friends is a novel writer that likes mystery, or not a policeman or an investigator. That's too easy. But maybe someone that is very intelligent in school, they used to do the same thing, solve mysteries as kids. But now this is a real mystery, and they take the challenge and they intervene. Mm-hmm. They interfere sometimes with the police investigation. They say, hey, don't intervene, go back to your cities. No, but we're going to solve this by our own. And the story goes there, and we get all the clues through the eyes of this friend, that they are four or five, I don't know, like a... And we get flashbacks of them when they were kids doing something similar. That sounds nice. Mm-hmm.
That could be an awesome story. It could be in a way a little bit like Citizen Kane type of story, where this person, the investigating character, has to interview every friend and figure out what those things that the friends are telling, the stories about the past, which one of those provides a valuable clue into the disappearance. And the other thing to investigate is, of course, the mechanics of the disappearing. How could it possibly happen? And then the third thing to investigate is which one of these characters is responsible, because somehow it becomes obvious that one of the people present at the wedding has something to do with it and knows something. But which one of them, and which one is trying to provide false information and deceive the investigating character? All that becomes really fascinating, and it could be an amazing story. Let's take it into entirely. Go ahead, sorry.
This board game Clue, but they have made several movie adaptations of this. The six people in the mansion, there is a blackout, then the owner is killed, and the whole movie is trying to find out who did it. It's a board game, but they have made movies about that. But now it's not a mansion, it's a whole family and a wedding and a city trying to.
Who is responsible?
Okay.
Yep, exactly.
I've seen, now that you mentioned it, I've seen an amazing Chinese movie, which is a version of the same thing, but it's it's made very realistic and very gritty, because the story is about a it's a mainland Chinese movie, so nationalists, members of Chiang Kai-shek army are considered bad guys, and the members of Mao army are considered the good guys in the Chinese movies. So it's a situation in which one of the people invited into a mansion is a communist, and the Chiang Kai-shek official wants to figure out which one of them, and he has all of those people together, and they are all claim not to be a communist, but one of them is. So it's and it becomes this really interesting kind of intriguing story, because the stakes are mounting, and then eventually we realize it's about something else entirely. It's not even about communist or Chiang Kai-shek or nationalist thing, but about some personal stuff. So it's kind of a cool story, and it's a cool structure to apply to something more realistic, to some kind of dramatic, realistic events usually. But imagine that we apply a different pattern. Remember my story about a person who exchanges letters with our protagonist. So imagine that when we arrive to the wedding, everybody expects the bridegroom and the bride that they already know, but either one of them or both of those people are not who we expect. Okay. And only one person calls it out and says, guys, what is going on here? These are some strangers. We're coming to see our friends, but these are people I never met them. But everybody else insists that these are those people. These are exactly the bridegroom and the bride who they expected, their friends from many years. Only one person is going nuts over it and says, well, what are you talking about? These are not the same people, it's somebody else. Why are you trying, why are you playing the charade? And it's up to that character who all of a sudden is revealed to be the protagonist. Until then, we thought of that character as a minor character. But all of a sudden, that is the only character who is convinced that these people are faking it, that they are not bridegroom and the bride. And virtually everybody else around them says that they are. And he needs to expose the conspiracy and figure out what is going on here. Something like that. That's a pattern, but it's a pattern that could be effective and applied to any kind of story, including this one. So we could also use deliberately create some kind of left turn in a story and figure out what would be the wildest possible, the most unpredictable direction for that story to go to. And even before, even just now, we demonstrated a couple of wild and unpredictable directions. But what could be even wilder than that? What would be your take on that?
To give it a wild turn, we have to change the genre. No more comedy or rom-com.
Okay.
Action maybe.
Okay.
An action movie, but this was a setup. This was a setup, a very big charade, but. They needed it to be real, to sound real, to look real, because they needed someone specific to come to that wedding.
Awesome. Okay. Okay.
They had to deceive everybody, even friends and family, and these two people that are marrying, mm-hmm. they are actually not going to marry, but they were.
Okay.
Friends from some time in the past, but they're just both detectives or investigators, CIA, FBI, I don't know, something like that. And this was the only way for the operation to work, for this person to accept the invitation and actually be there present in the wedding to capture him.
Brilliant. You just gave them the absolutely brilliant idea. Exactly.
I will keep the point of view of the friends. I will keep the point of view of the friends that clueless, the most clueless characters in the story. That they like what the hell is going on? I will keep that for the audience. Yes.
Brilliant.
That's the best solution. It's better than everything else because, you know, it's a little bit more realistic than the two other versions that we came up with. The first, the closed room mystery, okay, cool, but kind of a little artificial. The second one is too fantastical. But this one is perfect. It's awesome. You just had an amazing idea for a story and it's all yours. You should write it. It's fantastic. Congratulations.
What more for my head? Oh my God. What more for my head? Yeah, I'm I have to figure out who this guy is, why is he wanted, and why is he invited to this, how credible the invitation is for this person to be here if it's a dangerous person, or something like that.